Okay, first place I can think to use it is in that odd scale thing. Although, before I do that, is this the note? Yeah, so this is the note. Don't read the other thing. Oh, is this Room of Redemption as in a prize redemption crane game? Let's find out. Let's not fall down into the pit. Okay. Feel like that did something. Let's try visiting my favorite spot to get zapped. Okay. Now we have a potential mini boss fight. Maybe I should have saved it. It's like a 3D driver's license. It proves that I'm small. Alright, so what's this gonna be like? Oh, that's encouraging. Oh, it's got all my weapons. Here's my favorite rolling shuriken. An axe, it's kind of like the thing, chakram. Regular shuriken, a shield. Those are actual chakrams. Well, down I go. Maybe the whip would be better. Maybe. Okay. Don't want to sit on top of the enemy. So I can bait him to put the shield lower and then attack the head. Okay. That was down to the wire. Oh! Okay. Alright. Probably shouldn't have been standing under the thing that was hanging from the ceiling. Let's save in the safest way possible. So I've got the key to Eternity. Wait, what? Okay. So I'm pretty sure I know where that's used. I have a feeling maybe I was supposed to drop that ceiling thing onto the mini boss or something like that. Oh. Right here. This is probably just another way out, but I want to make sure there's nothing hidden over here. Aha. Okay. It's a haunted stream. Okay, so I should probably head into the endless corridor. See if the fairy says anything. No. So, oh, we got some intel. Find this map. So this exits to two other places. Good to know. All right, that was pretty cool. A lot of doorways with symbols. Probably should have been writing way more notes. Okay, that is clearly a reference to numbers that Mulbrick was talking about earlier. I think. Maybe, maybe not. So ascension is 9. Beginning might be born. Lies maybe 2 or 3. Following kind of the pattern of the early numbers. Not sure about reproduce. Probably should take a look through my notes and get rid of things I don't need anymore. Oh, the music changed too. Or maybe I just had never gotten that far into the song before. The mini boss I just defeated. Wish there was a way to move notes around, but that's okay. Okay, that enemy is pooping fire. Yes, I can very... Oops. Maybe I didn't want to do that. Because the infinity symbol is... Well, I don't know. Let's look over here first. So even just passing by the markers will cause them to be set, for lack of a better term. Might have to actually draw this as a map. These stairways and one-way doors and all this is going to be hard to reproduce otherwise. Grand level. Ladder. Percent sign. I want to say that thing is the twin labyrinth. Oops, there's a ladder there. So if I go through this doorway, does everything reset? No. Got to note this wall. Get up there yet. Okay, so next room over. Did I mess up my map? Sure did. And this side, that is a ceiling. This is a walled off area. Some of these symbols are all something. Confusing. So the top half is completely separated, oh, except for that ladder. Some of these are suspiciously kanji-like, but I don't think that necessarily means anything. Key sword. Doesn't seem so bad. If I go partway through and then back, it doesn't count. If I travel all the way through, then it does count. The same symbol as in the other room. Okay. I was expecting something either good or bad to happen. But I was not expecting nothing to happen. I go up. Okay, that does reset. So if this game does not have a bestiary, I'm very curious what's going on with this enemy right here. Let's see. The saved note does not include the highlighting. Or these could be references to the various areas and the symbols that mark them. So and not necessarily related to numbers. Because there were two of these just below me. So why would there be two of those? And if I drew the other ones fairly well, then I don't see any other duplicates. So I wonder if you're not supposed to step through the ones just below me. Is there a path through here that would only go through four? If I were to go through here, I would be forced to go through that. Oh no, I could go down through here. But on the return trip, left or right, I would need to go through either this one or the one above me. It's probably never gonna get old. Oh, that's a wall right there. So this one, the percent sign or the twin labyrinth are required to make a full circuit. And then if I were in this room going left or right, I could avoid everything by taking that upper route. Here I can duck down. Assuming the enemies don't knock me in. No, I have to do something. Okay. Maybe I should try pairing up the symbols with areas. There's way more areas than there are digits. So the surface may not have a number, which I guess makes sense. Okay, so this would go to spring in the sky. Okay, so this does have a symbol for the Gate of Guidance. I'm jotting this down correctly. It's the one in the very first room that ladder takes me down. And that's the symbol for spring in the sky, which is in the next room over, the kind of pyramid-shaped room where I got the key sword. Or the front side and the back side say share the same symbol. Because that doorway looks a lot like... that other symbol. It's like the Mausoleum of Giants. This goes to the Temple of the Sun. Okay, so actually, I do want to go down this way. So this should be the Inferno Cavern. Inferno Cavern. So going down isn't going to help me because I don't think there is a symbol. Okay, that's good to know. Thank you, Mulberg. This path does not require the use of weights. This does not seem to match up with any of those symbols, I don't think. In this area, probably not going to have any symbols. Yep. Those both lead to places I've already been to. This has paths everywhere. So this doorway would be... no. Tower of Ruin? Oh, they flip left to right. Okay. So maybe that other symbol is that. Then, if this is Inferno Cavern, that flip side of this has a completely different... Alright. Getting slightly more confused now. Okay, infinite corridor. Kind of makes sense. Thank you. This would be Mausoleum of... No. Symbol flips around. Graveyard of Giants. So this is which symbol? More importantly, where is that leading? Leads to the Gate of Illusion. So oops, wrong flip. Through the power of MS Paint, that is the reverse of the Gate of Guidance. Chamber of Extinction. Well, this is not the best place to go if I want to see the symbol of the area. I want to go to... Wait, did I already? Yeah, I did figure this one out. Okay. Well, there's apparently many hidden rooms above me. That would be accessible from the flip side of wherever that is. might be the Tower of the Mother. Okay, I think that is Shrine of the Mother. Heal going again. Here again real quick. Clearly something to do there. Maybe that gets unlocked later. Tower of Goddess is the same symbols as the tower, Inferno Tower? It's confusing. Although maybe the doorways don't quite mean what I think they do. That would be going to the Tower of the Goddess, but... Alright. So then what's the one below me? That is the Tower of Ruin. These are on the same side. Then Twin Labyrinths is the only one I haven't been to. I think there's a quick exit to the right. So that would be I know I've seen that symbol before. Temple of Moonlight. So I'm not actually sure what this symbol is, because this is the flip side of it. The one in the upper right corner here. Because the one in the infinite corridor is pointed the other direction. Okay. And there's the mystery symbol that shows up twice, but I don't know what area that refers to. Are there parts on my map that I don't have scans for? No. Okay.